Okay. Okay. You've made a mistake saying I cannot run this race. It's playtime. I'm gonna crush your.
So the topic that was sent across to me was to kind of talk about all the challenges that an entrepreneur faces typically while setting up an e-commerce establishment. Any of you all want to become an entrepreneur, you have to actually ask yourself, why do you need to kind of get into this model? Why should you be setting up something of your own? A lot of your ideas, whatever you're thinking, would have already been implemented by somebody. And that is what you will kind of come across when you're competing with all the big ones out there. So always remember, your first concept, your initial step has to be absolutely well thought of. Ki mujhe ye karna hai because I will plug this gap in the market. And a lot of you guys into marketing and all would have already heard this term of being differentiated. So what is that differentiated value proposition is what you need to kind of think about. Coming to an e-commerce website, right? There are only three things that you would kind of come across in terms of the concern areas. One is, how do I drive traffic to my website? So how, as a digital marketer or a website owner, can I actually communicate my product better to you? Because all I have is a web screen or a phone device. So the biggest challenge, again, after that I get traffic, assuming I get traffic by spending money, the second biggest challenge is, what is this traffic doing? Only 25% overall in the industry on the last page purchase the product. So the checkout experience also has to be good. So do I have Paytm? Do I have MobiQuick? Do I have various models? For interestingly for you guys, I want to tell you, what we've got on our website is something called Buy Now, Pay Later. So a lot of people live on pocket money, for example. Or teri girlfriend ko teko gift karna hoga, to kaise karega? Tera pocket money tune bahar uda diya. Kya karoge? You buy now and you pay later when your pocket money comes in. And lastly, all you need to understand is, one of the biggest roles and drivers of e-commerce or any digital thing would be data. All these big companies, even including us, like a small company, we do a lot of data mining. We understand browsing behavior. We understand purchase behavior. So Pooja and Rituraj are two separate individuals having separate tastes. She's looking for women's bags. He's looking for adventurous bags. Why should they both see the same homepage? Why should it not be personalized? And that personalized e-commerce is going to be the next big thing. But today you are hit and bombarded with so many irrelevant offers that marketing today is not personalized.
And that customer service and customer retention is going to be huge. And that's again a challenge, because a lot of times, like what you're saying, you did not get a damaged product or whatever, the entire effort to return it or replace it or get your refund is so cumbersome today.
E-commerce today is just in its preliminary step, wherein you're seeing websites interacting with you. And it is truly complete when your daily objects are going to be interacting with you. The world that we live in will always exist and will always remain physical. So how do you merge the physical world into the virtual world and also enable purchase? That is the future of e-commerce. Big data is a loosely thrown term today. Okay, but the fundamental of it is very interesting, is when it says that today all of us leave behind something called a digital exhaust. Everybody has a little digital stamp that he or she has left behind. It's like a cookie crumble that you have left behind. All of this data is unstructured. Aapne Facebook pe kuch kiya, aapne search pe kuch kiya, aapne website pe kuch kiya. Aise aapne bahut interactions kiye digitally with multiple mediums. How do I pull all this unstructured data and structure it in various columns? And then once it is structured, what can I do and understand from a data science perspective or a data analytics perspective to sell you better relevant offers? And coming to the last point is, what would a store of the future, because in my head, the physical world will always exist and e-commerce dunya will never overtake the physical realities of the world. What will happen is, the online world will merge with the offline world or the physical world so beautifully that your entire experience will become cashless, will become seamless, and you'll have a fantastic experience that you think at the back of your mind while you're buying. I want you guys to pull out your phones and do a simple calculation. What is 0.99 raised to power of 365? 1.01 raised to 365 kitna hai? 1.01. Now understand this well. If you do just 1% of your life better for 365 days in a year, you will be miles ahead of the competition. One % a day. Just 1% a day effort for just 1 year will set you aside that far. That's it.
If you're strong enough, then take us all then. Put a mask over the Sultan. Somewhere dark we assault him.
Kill the king. Good experience. We got to know about many things. Like he talked about IoT and stuff like that. Like big data. It was a nice experience talking about that stuff.
It was a very good and inspiring speech for us.
He was very intellectual. I got to know a lot about e-commerce.
He was really very inspiring. And a lot of things, like the things which he told apart from e-commerce was like much more helpful for us.
I might be quite pretentious. Here's some knowledge I'm lending. Mine sounds pretending. I might be quite pretentious. Here's some knowledge I'm lending. My name withholds a legend of a king losing his head in. That's my definition of he who had descended.